My aunt took me by the hand and my sister Ruth. They heard daddy was coming to the college, American college over there, and everybody can go and meet their loved ones. And I remember this life a picture, my daddy with a long coat down to the floor, you know, something around his cap on his head. The two, three of his friends coming. And he said, "That's your daddy, that's your..." I ran away.
Oh, you're so happy to see him.
We come home.
That's when he came home to Eintab, huh?
He came to Eintab.
You were so happy to see him.
Yeah, and it didn't last long. I remember the I could hear the cannon roaring, the French cannon in the Turkish quarters, bombarding them, you know. We had to leave. My father knew this. 3 months before that, he came to Aleppo, find a place for us, find a job. And when we found the place for us, we packed everything. My mother had friends, they came and packed. And the packs came to a place outside the city, because next morning the caravan was going to carry everybody that is ready to go to Aleppo, Syria, from Turkey. We were fleeing the Turks. That night I remember, we came with big windows, we had our weddings in them, whatever we had, our clothes, you couldn't bring furniture or anything, oh, everybody had a... Well, that night when it rained, everything was soaked, and my mother, my mother's stepmother was together with us. They went to hire a car carriage for us and told me to take care of the baby. And Ruth was with me also. And when mommy came, "Where's the baby? Where's the baby? We removed it. The baby is under the quilt. He's not breathing." I said, "Where's the baby? Grandma got the baby. The baby doesn't look like alive. She beat him like this on the back, patted him, and the baby opened his eyes." Oh, my mom. "What am I going to tell his father? What am I going to tell his father?" That's the way mom was going.
Oh, my goodness.
Araba.
Carriage.
Ne arabası?
Carriage. Horse-drawn carriage.
Not horse.
Mule drawn carriage?
Yeah. And my mother went found this one. They came and put our things in there, made room for us to sit in there. And it started raining. I remember mommy had a umbrella, the baby in her arms, of the baby, 2-4-month-old baby, in her arms. She and I lying under the pillow in the air. quilts, you know. And it's raining. It rained all night.
Oh, wow.
And next morning, everything that was left on the floor, soaking in mud. We stayed in those carriages 3 nights. Three nights and 3 days.
You were traveling for 3 days?
3 nights and 3 days.
To get to the train station?
To get to Aleppo, where the train station was. Outside the city. We had outside the town. We had to get on those trains. Finally, one afternoon, we saw Aleppo. You know, everybody was on top of their luggage on the car, on the...
They were open cars,
trains,
huh?
Trains.
Like flat cars.
Yeah, everybody had everything, everyone sat on it.
Huh, right on top of your luggage, huh?
Yeah. So everybody was clapping. And then I saw my aunt. Hey! She has come. Aunt Rosa, my mom's sister.
Aunt Rosa?
Yeah. She came.
Bart?
To meet us. My father couldn't come. He was busy looking at a place for us. So Auntie Rosa got a carriage for us, loaded us and brought us home that my father had rented for us already. And that's how we got to Aleppo.
Wow.